Yeah, that's fine.
He waxes his knife on me.
And you, sir?
I'm good. I'm good. No, I'm just, I'm gonna have some water here.
Sure.
I'm good. Thank you. So what's up, Kelly? What's going exciting in the life of Kelly Pavlik?
Everything, babe.
Like what?
Well, did James tell you about the podcast?
It's called The James Dominguez and Kelly Pavlik, or is it Kelly Pavlik, James Dominguez?
Kelly Pavlik.
Keep that fucking camera on me. Okay.
It's the show here. It's called The Knockout.
No.
The Punchline.
Punchline. The Punchline.
I was close.
Yes.
Punch, Knockout.
If you don't like the show, I'll punch you in the mouth.
Punch
twice.
It's been a while, Ellie.
Okay, where can we find
it? Like,
if I'm going to go on the internet.
Like, we never lost base, you know what I mean? No, you know what? Right now, that's a work in progress. We're working on...
we had a radio station.
Yeah, we were on NEO Sports Insider.
Out of Cleveland. NEO Sports.
But if I'm in LA, how can I listen to it?
We did have links through our Facebook
and
social media. That's all going to be up and running here, and then eventually it's going to be on the YouTube. Probably by this week.
That's really cool.
Trying to get big like you, man.
It's easy. Just work. But let me ask you this. Chavez Jr. Canelo, what do you guys think? You were supposed to fight Chavez Jr. at one point. They were talking about it.
Everyone was talking about it. Now, you know what? I think that's going to be actually an interesting fight. You know, Chavez is going to come in bigger, you know, naturally bigger. And Canelo, you know, I think he's an excellent fighter. I think he's talented. So it's going to be interesting. I mean, I don't know if that weight's going to make a difference. It did in the Danny Jacobs Triple G fight. In my opinion, that knockdown, that weight difference was the difference between a knockdown and a knockout. I don't know, man. I think it's going to be interesting.
How would Kelly Pavlik fight Triple G?
Same way. I mean, first of all, I don't think he likes going backwards. I don't think he likes getting hit. And I don't think he knows how to react when he hits somebody and they don't go nowhere. I think one thing I showed in my career is I can take a shot. You know,
I'm a naturally big middleweight. I wasn't.
And a big puncher.
Wasn't naturally big middleweight.
What do you know?
He said he could take a shot.
How much? 203. That's cruiserweight.
In shape, 200.
No.
That's true.
Oh, yeah, the UFC fighter I have.
Matt Brown.
Yeah, Matt fight. Brown. What's that name though?
Immortal.
Yeah, Matt the Immortal Brown. You know what that is?
No, but if he's immortal, he must be good.
He's on the one, what do you call that series?
Ultimate Fighter. Season 7.
Honestly, I'm cool with Nate Diaz and other, like John Jones, but I don't really follow the UFC.
Yeah.
I just know that Mayweather, if he fights McGregor won't be able to do anything.
No, he's going to get, beat up.
Yeah, I don't know, you know, I mentioned something about that. I was asked a question about that. And I said, I could kind of understand because of the money. No, MMA, they don't make money.
Unfortunately, they don't. That's my beef with the UFC. Yeah. I want to see the fighters get paid.
It's almost like a monopoly, but they make a lot more in endorsements than boxers do.
Not anymore.
You know, they don't.
They used to. They used to have like 10 sponsors. Each sponsor, 100,000.
Now,
do Reebok.
But either or, I mean,
30,000 a year for Reebok.
This is going to be a big chance for McGregor. I think when McGregor makes good money, what I'm saying, though. I mean, he gets from probably his country, his hometown, his country. He makes good money, but this is going to be something totally different for him. You know, the amount of money he can make. On the other hand, I don't know how much credibility he's going to lose because it's not like he's going to go in there and it's going to be a good fight. He's going to go in there and get his ass whipped. You know what I mean?
Well, you have other UFC fighters saying it's a joke. Other pro UFC
like who?
Like Matt Brown, he said it was a joke. The fight, he said that he didn't get hurt.
No, are they going to be using like boxing gloves or UFC gloves?
Boxing gloves.
Okay, that's a whole different.
Not much.
Does this count as Floyd's 50th fight?
Huh?
Is this Floyd's 50th?
Yeah, I mean,
I would have
probably. It's more of a celebrity type of fight.
Yeah, but if Conor McGregor's license.
That's
which
it.
He has to be.
He's only licensed in California.
Mayweather's got to be licensed.
Nevada already approved the fight.
Yeah. So that obviously right there, you know, that's a fight. That's a sanctioned fight.
Okay, who in the UFC would you want to box?
Oh, I don't know.
Nick Diaz.
It would have to be a heavyweight. No.
Yeah, it would.
John Jones.
Heavyweight.
Oh shit.
Brock Lesnar.
They have me bent
like a pretzel, man. Although I've been doing that jiu-jitsu. I was taking that for a little bit. I want to get back into it. It was fun. Not competitive though.
If you had to choke James Dominguez out, how fast can you do it?
What happened?
And what happened? Right
what happened, James?
What happened?
Well, James is a beast, man.
I know.
He's
I see him.
He, you know what? Actually, James got a big background in that jiu-jitsu too.
There you go.
Well, you got blue belt.
Blue belt.
Yeah.
Where is it, Gracie or?
Under Vitor Oliveira. Yeah.
That's very cool.
Hey, I had to defend myself. I wasn't very athletic growing up.
Kelly Pappas, let me ask you this. When you go to the airport, who's the one celebrity they confuse you with the most? Because when someone
Agassi.
It happens on a regular basis?
Butterbean.
No, I don't see Butterbean. I see Agassi. What do you tell them if they see Agassi? Where's Brooke Shields?
I haven't. I mean, most people at airports I've been, they knew it was me.
And what did they say?
But I haven't. Are you coming back? What are you fighting? I haven't traveled much since I retired, so usually when I was fighting, my face was fresh out there.
Did you tell them about the time you went to that concert? How many fans were out there?
Oh yeah.
My God.
Yeah.
What happened?
We went to a concert.
A metal concert, rock concert.
Was
it Metallica?
Slipknot.
Slipknot.
There must have been 5,000 fans that came to him just in that.
In the mosh pit?
Yeah, that
was crazy. It was crazy. Yeah. They just surrounded him and like, oh shit.
That was only 2 years ago too.
Yeah, he's been the whole concert signing autographs.
That's really cool.
That's awesome. Man.
Taking pictures.
So you've been busy as shit, right? What's been the greatest? Can I hold your camera?
Kelly Pavlik, taking over.
Hey, this is a part of my routine, homie. What's been the best show you've done in the last 2 years?
Chavez Jr., Chavez Sr. together in the gym, very focused. Chavez Sr. showing Jr. what moves to do, how to counterpunch Canelo.
At 10 Goose Boxing Gym, right?
Yeah.
Hey, could you do me a favor when you're there?
Sure.
Can you find like that little case where they have the shirts and hoodies and hats?
Sure.
Grab like two or three of them.
They're right in the
what size?
Oh man, any size.
Okay, we'll do it.
Yeah, I guess the Jack Luna runs that gym. The Jackaloon, Ricky.
Oh, why did you call him Jackaloon?
Because he promised shirts and never sent them to Kelly.
I'll remind him.
I told him we better get one.
Hey, remember if you said you had money.
Hold on. We're going to call him right now.
Don't ask him when he's in a bad mood.
Why?
Put him on the spot.
What happened when you asked him for my shirt?
Oh, man.
What happened?
$20.
Yeah.
You, Marco. How's everything been, buddy?
Everything's good. We're pretty busy in Oxnard.
You're still in the sport, man. You a hustler.
You're still there on the wall. So
am I? You guys take care of me too.
I see you every day, man. So that's gonna stick. That's gonna stay. If you're probably moved on, that's gonna stay.
Keep that lotion on my head, so I don't want to get it all ashy.
I'm ashy to classy.
And my man here, with my favorite trainer, personal trainer.
Yes, sir.
You're doing good, see? You're doing good. You're always busy too, man.
Yeah, man.
Yeah.
Hey, Ricky. How are you?
Oh, here you go. Ricky on the phone.
Here we go.
Kelly Pavlik. Oh, here's Cecilio.
What's up, brother? How are you?
Here's Marco.
Sorry.
Here's James Dominguez. He's from Dominguez Hills.
Hey,
here's Kelly Pavlik.
Sorry.
Oh, is he on a pooper? Get that close.
Taking a dookie.
We got Rick Funyuns on a shitter.
Hey, you're the second person I'm calling. I'm gonna call on the toilet. The first one.
No, I'm good.
You know that I called Andre Brito to ask him about does he want to fight John Porter, and he was also on the toilet. So Ricky.
Yeah, look at that. Look, he's even got that face he's making. He's pushing.
He wanted to know where our shirt.
Show him his lion face. Show him your lion face.
Is that your lion face?
That's your lion face.
He bent down. TMI.
Hell, this might be your best show, man.
Where is Kelly Pavlik's shirt?
They're in the mill. FedEx messed it up.
They're in the mail.
Yeah.
He says he hasn't got them yet.
We got an email confirmation, buddy.
I sent them out this week. They're not there yet.
Tracking them.
Nobody got him yet.
He had no return address on there.
Yeah, return address.
What's up, Ricky?
Tell him we're going to bring Rudy Hernandez back on and roast him.
Rudy got him.
He said
you're
going to bring Rudy back on and they're going to roast you. That's your skank?
Yeah.
Okay, all right, Ricky. All right,
my arm's getting tired.
All right, later. Don't forget the wife. So, Kelly, but life is good. You're smiling. You're looking healthy. You're happy.
Yeah, doing good, man. Doing good.
Is boxing doing good in general? Are you following the sport?
No, I've been now. You know, I mean, I still always followed it. You know, I mean, don't get me wrong on that. No, boxing right now it's kind of like making its way back. I think with the Lomachenkos, the Virgos, I think, you know, actually, your Thurmans, your Sean Porters.
Earl Spence.
Earl Spence.
I think he destroys Kell Brook.
Kell Brook. I think these are going to be the fights that actually, though, all those different guys, it's kind of almost, not the same, so I don't want anybody getting pissed, but it's kind of going to be like the Hearns, Hagler, Duran, you know, Leonard. You know, all these guys fight mask would be interesting for boxing again. Of course, I think that was great for boxing with the rematch with Ward and Kovalev. I think that's what the fans want to see. You know, so, you know, and then this Canelo-Chavez fight. I don't care what anybody says. True boxing fans know that's still going to be an interesting, good fight. Okay, now your guys out there that can kind of follow the sport are going to be like, well, Chavez ain't done this and that.
They want Triple G Canelo. And
yeah, but situations, I'm not going to say styles, but certain situations make fights too. And as a winner of that, you know, I think with the way that fight went with Jacobs and Triple G, I think that makes the fight a lot more realistic with him and Canelo. Or should, you know, because now, like, Triple G is not this impossible guy to beat.
He looked beautiful.
Yeah, he did. So, I think there's a lot of positive things to come with this sport. Boxing is going to take black eyes, though. It's going to take it, man. You're going to have, like, the UFC that's going to beat it on weekly ratings. But if you look at the pay-per-view sales and big fights, boxing is always going to be the sweet science, and it's never going to die.
How good is Mikey Garcia? Did you watch his last fight?
Dude, Mikey, I'm not saying this either. I'm not being a butt kisser.
That's right, you said butt is not ass.
Man, or ass kisser, right? Mikey's a legit man. They kick the box, he can punch, he can bang, he can take a punch. He's legit. And there's no getting around that either. I mean, his hand speed, his power, he's got the whole entire package.
I think he beats an artist.
Can't wait to see that fight.
All right, we're going to let Kelly Pavlik eat for a couple minutes here. What are you having, Kelly? It looks like a steak.
Yeah.
Is it a duck?
I don't know here, man, at these fancy restaurants. It's a beef.
What kind of animal?
You think she's a slut? That's a good thing. No, get back in the kitchen and make it a pizza.
All right, there you have it, Kelly Pavlik. Make sure to tune in to The Punchline with Kelly Pavlik and James Dominguez. Are you on Instagram?
We are.
Yeah, we have been put on there.
What's it called?
The Punchline.
The Punchline.
Okay, no underscores, no underline. The Punchline.
All right, stay
tuned.
The Punchline?
See if I can find you guys.
You guys gotta come on.
DisneyReport.com, right? Super recording.
Yeah. No, you know it. Yeah.
Why do they call him the ghost?
Why?
White. He's no super rope. Fast.
No, that's
you can't. You can't see.
There you go. Ellie Dallas. You ever get interviewed by Ellie? He knows how to throw little curveballs in there. Nobody really knows the true reason why it's the ghost, but there was two or three incidents. Why? One, I was a white kid and I fought pretty good. Two, I was really a good defensive fighter when I was young. And then three, they were calling me ghost up in Cleveland, the other fighters, when I had real good defense. Or maybe because I was white. And then I came home and I showed the video. Now, this is back when they had tape cassettes, okay? You've probably never seen one of those. And my brother was watching the fight, and he goes, man, he's like, you look like a ghost in there. So it was kind of a coincidence that they, you know, Ghost was coming up like twice that day. And at that time, nobody had the nickname Ghost. So.
Robert Guerrero.
At that
Ooh,
time.
Oh, was that before?
That was after.
That was after. You're the original.
Casper.
Oh, gee. Yeah.
That's what I call my son, Casper. Yeah, so those are the reasons why.
Your son's an actor.
And I pretty much, I took it out of coincidence, I said. Maybe my nickname is meant to be the ghost, you know? So, we get mistaken, but it's...
What do you think is the best heavyweight?
Ever or now?
Of all time. We had this...
You know, seeing as where people get mad at me, I don't think it's all me.
Yeah, me neither.
Yeah, but in the Butterbean. Heavyweight division, yeah, I would have to say probably.
Marco said Butterbean.
But you know, the funny thing is this. Now, I'm going to ask you guys, for the boxing people, you look at Joe Frazier, and when he broke Ali's jaw and some of the close fights. If you take the fighting style of Joe Frazier, which is very similar to Mike Tyson, they were like almost the same height, they both were the bob weave, Frazier was notorious for a left hook, powerful left hook. Mike Tyson was super fast and powerful in both hands. And a lot faster than Frazier. Tyson was faster than Frazier. If Frazier was able to get in and hit Ali with that hook, Tyson, I think Tyson would have. Ali was not hard to hit. Ali ended up with a lot of damage from the rope and dope. You know, he had broken jaws in his fight. His fights. I'm not saying Tyson would win, but I don't think if people say, oh, Ali would box his ears off and it would be an easy win, I don't see that happening.
Yeah.
But just break that down for a minute. I mean,
I think Lennox Lewis.
Yeah, well, Lewis was getting beat by Vitaly.
They stopped it on the injury over the eye at Staples Center. But he's very good too. He's legendary.
Oh yeah.
So who's fighting tomorrow then?
Vasyl Lomachenko and Jason Sosa.
Which one of you men?
No, he's upstairs sleeping.
He's sleeping. Oh, he's sleeping. Right.
He's gonna coach
sleeping.
One of the fighters. Yeah. He's a coach. He's a radio personality. He's has knowledge, and he's a trainer with the fighter.
Okay. So anyway.
Hi, how are you?
Good luck.
Thank you, thank you.
Thank you. Thank you, ma'am.
Do not stumble over your words.
For me. I don't do that. Do I?
And
do
you? I stumble over my words? I heard you talk about Steve Curry.
No, because I said you're a radio personality.
You know you're basketball.
Ah, you're eavesdropping.
Right. He just talks shit to talk shit. You don't have a reason. He just does. Even to talk shit, he's not training.
You see Brandon all the time?
Hold on, let's see if we can get him on the phone really quick. He might not pick up.
But it's,
if he
picks still up, early over there.
Yeah,
it's only 6:30.
What?
Let's go with Mario, PG Michael.
Yeah.
Who's going to just call me? George, take a picture with the champ.
What is he called? Pinche what?
Pinche puto?
I got a whole thing in my tonight.
He tried to say Monte Carlo, but only Puerto Ricans say that. I didn't say that.
There you go, right there. There you go, beautiful, right there. Hold on, one more, one more. Joy, that's my man right there.
My man,
good job, baby.
I'm gonna put you on my Instagram right now, buddy.
Where's your dad?
My dad. He went to
the right there. He's right there.
I came with Vadik.
We're trying to get a hold of Brandon Reels. We'll see if he picks up.
Oh, I'm sorry. Do you want me to take care of it, or you got it? Sure.
Who do you think was better?
I got it.
Ward Kovalev.
Two.
A rematch. You were supposed to fight Andre Ward before you announced.
Yeah, that was the main, one of the big reasons for that. the last fight I thought was a good fight. A lot of people were disappointed in that fight. You know, I thought it was a good fight overall. I thought Kovalev won that fight, by two or three rounds. My thing is this, everybody says, oh, well, Ward landed the good body shots. He landed like one clean body shot around. A lot of times those were in the clinch. You know, you hit Kovalev on the clinch, the body. That's not enough in a 3-minute round for me to go, he won that round. You know, I thought he definitely picked it up towards the end of the fight, later rounds. The Kovalev I had on the head, you know, that knockdown was big. The rematch, Ward's a smart fighter. Really smart, so I'm sure he's going to come out and he's going to change like he did in the first fight. You know, that the first half of that fight and the second half were two totally different fights. So now that he's got more time training and more film breakdown, yeah, it's going to be an interesting fight.
Do you agree?
You're saying it'll be a closer fight?
I don't pick the winners in this because for me, if I have one person loses it or I'm wrong, I get drilled for that. So I learned how to say it's going to be an interesting fight.
You know what I always say my answer is? The fans are the winners. Who's going to win? The fans are the winners. That way nobody gets offended.
That's how you keep fans. That's
it. So Kelly Pavlik, James Dominguez, podcast radio show. How long has it been going on?
A month.
Yeah, about a month. Maybe a little more.
We're on our fourth episode.
Yeah.
Who's on the show usually? Who do you put on?
Well, we had Mikey Garcia on one of our first episodes. We had Ann Wolf, Rudy Hernandez. We have an Olympian coming on. Was it Amanda? Ricky Funes came on. Amanda.
Trainer of Stars.
Yeah.
Trainer to the Stars.
Trainer of Stars. And then we just had We have some Olympic speed skater coming on.
So we're here with Kelly Pavlik, James Dominguez. They have a brand new radio show. It's called The Punchline. Do you guys just talk boxing or football, basketball,
everything.
Soccer,
everything.
Ping pong, Playboy, everything?
Yeah. Listen, we got two actually. We got picked up. Ineo Sports Insider out of Cleveland came and wanted to pick our show up. So we do that show with them. And a lot of our friends on social, on Facebook, know how we like the joke. You know what I mean?
Wild.
We put some, yeah, you know Mark.
And
No limits.
Yeah, and it's mainly just memes and shit like that. But but we have that with them. Obviously, that has to be kind of like G-rated. Then we have Kelly Powell, or the punchline with Kelly Powell, James Dominguez after the belt. And that's where, you know, the gloves come off a little bit. And
What is it, after midnight, after 11 p.m.?
We have strippers on there. Yeah. We got everything going on.
We have halos on there.
We have halos on
because he became like a psychiatrist now. Oh, that was funny as shit.
Halos?
He's in college to become a
become
a counselor.
He studied.
So we brought him on to counsel this woman who has emotional problems.
And he worked?
Yeah.
Not really, but it was funny as hell. Like, we brought this chick on here who's a train wreck, right?
Yeah.
Who's like been abused her whole life, used by the men. We brought him to try to talk her down.
No, didn't work.
It was a great show, though.
God.
She goes, "Can I have your phone number?" He's like, "Sure, I'll give you my phone number."
So how can you hear your show?
On
Facebook. Go to Facebook. You have the links there. What's the Facebook? The Punchline?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Or Kelly Pavlik?
They'll tell them a new one. They get on SoundCloud.
SoundCloud. It's on SoundCloud, too, under the Punchline.
Okay, from now on, you have to have a Punchline hat, a Punchline sweatshirt, a Punchline...
Listen, we got a website that's going to be done. Actually, the girl that set up with Lee Samuels, our PR woman, Amy Green.
Yeah, she's emailed me.
Yeah, okay. That's who, right now, the guy that she has, that website will be done. So there's going to be links on the website.
Yeah.
Like I said, it's going to be going to YouTube, you know, by this week. And then we're going to have all the links, too. Redone.
We got shirts and everything too. Should have brought
merchandise.
Should have brought some strippers.
Oh, you know what? I mean, we even did a show on paranormal.
Ellie, you like strippers?
Yeah. Who doesn't like strippers?
You're a married man.
But
now.
You're
who?
He's a married man.
But now I'm gonna ask you.
You're
this
eating
though.
A salad. Do you still look at like a steak?
Now I heard that that you do this though. I heard like when they're bent over dancing, you take your credit card out, you slide down their boot crack, and you take the money off their butt cheeks.
There you go.
That's more Pileta style, but...
Have you had any stats, or...
Okay,
which tennis match did he win?
No. Talk about...
Which tennis match did he win?
Talk about basketball, or talk about...
All right. Try to stop him. Stephen Curry has multiple records in the 2015-2016 season. He has most three-pointers in a game, most three-pointers in a season, most three-pointers in playoffs, most three-pointers in a quarter, and most three-pointers per possession.
You boys show home
okay, I got one to stop you. That's really good. That is awesome. What was my record?
What did you ask, Kelly?
What was the question?
What was my record?
Oh.
I got it.
I don't know.
Okay. 40-2, 34 knockouts.
There you go.
Who named the 34 fighters he knocked out?
He'll remember that.
Everybody.
He
was
good. Can you name the 34 people you knocked out?
Jason Sosa's record.
Jason Sosa's 18-1. Lomachenko's a part of that? Or Sammy Sosa?
Are you looking it up?
No, I'm looking for a picture.
Sosa's what? All
right, he's going to get Jason Sosa.
Right?
Go ahead.
20-1 and 4. I just did some guy that's not really famous.
Now, where do you go to find these stats at for like boxing?
Box Rec.
Yes, there you go. That's good. You know why? If somebody ever tells you, I used to be a pro fighter, you know how you call it a bluff? You go on, all right, hold on one second, buddy. You just go right to Box Rec.
I'll be right back.
Or if they were a pro fighter and say, I did it to him. He's like, yeah, I'm like 7-1 right now. And he's kind of from my area. 7-1. I go on Box Rec and I put his name in. The dude is like literally 1-7. And then I asked him.
Maybe
about
he got
it.
Confused.
No, he goes, bad management. They put me in on short notice.
But he really won those fights.
What do you know about Box Rec? So.
Hey, some guy in LA is a trainer in a gym and he puts ads, I won championships. And I looked him up, he didn't ever fight.
Yeah, no.
I'm like, how did you win championships? You never fought.
That dude in San Francisco does that. There's that carries
the
WBC belt around and never fought before.
Yep.
See, you're stealing the wall.
Who's that dude?
The wall. They gotta keep me up.
You know what I'm talking about?
What I'm worried about?
He's a trainer up in the Bay Area.
So I don't know him, but it sounds...
Yeah, he carries the WBC belt, and he takes pictures with it. Like he's a champion.
They're always gonna be up there. They're always gonna be up there.
They're all gonna be intact.
I see you every day, man.
Did you build a new house? You were in the process of construction.
I am in a... It's hard to explain. I'm getting a house. I'm looking for property in a certain place in Boardman, Ohio. But the only thing is, there's not much property there. So I'm waiting to see. I'm not staying with the kids. And but yeah, no, I got to get me a house. I
Who was
property.
Your best opponent?
Best opponent, I would have to say, overall talent wise, would be Jermaine Taylor. And then I'd have to say.
Sergio.
Oh, yeah, I'd have to say Sergio and some toss up between Sergio and Bernard. Both phenomenal fights.
Who was Martinez, your easiest fight?
Really, Martinez is a really good fighter.
His easiest fight?
His easiest
he fight. Has too many.
Yeah.
He made them
He easy. Has too many fights.
Listen, I got my sidekick here, okay? So he screens the questions. He's screening them and then he has to be approved.
The punchline.
Yes.
Okay, who is the biggest puncher you ever faced?
Miranda, for sure.
Edison.
Miranda is a beast, man.
You know he was wanted by the FBI and the CIA and Interpol?
Miranda?
What? He got busted.
Did he
get busted?
No, they're looking for him, but he's popping up on Facebook in different cities, so I laugh. But they're looking. He was importing cocaine from Colombia.
Wow.
And they arrested like 18 people. They were looking for him.
Well, what? So they busted a. They busted a.
That was really
the 100, the featherweight champion, was fucking 6 months ago.
Yeah.
What's his name?
Oh, he is. From last night.
Caballero.
What happened?
Is it Caballero?
I think so.
Yeah, they busted Cecilia, that guy. Do you know his nickname?
Of course.
Yeah.
The goat.
Right. Do you know what happened in the women's final four this year?
Yes. Spain had a buzzer beater to win against UConn, and they broke their 11-11
It's good, bro.
Yeah,
he's awesome.
He's good. I can make a fortune in this game.
I need him on my side for like every sports argument.
He has a photographic memory.
I did not watch the game for any man. That's Saturday morning.
Who's better, him or the gentleman? Huh? Who's better, him or the gentleman?
And I'm standing there waiting for someone to say April Fools. And they didn't say April Fools. And it was like, I'll be April Fools.
All right, so Kelly, anything else to add? Anything to tell your fans if they're watching?
I was watching Curry and Harden.
Yeah, man. Thanks for being fans. You know, thanks for standing behind me. Stay tuned. You know, I got a lot more, you know, in the sport of boxing to do. And it's going to be, you know, exciting. Like I said, eventually I'll be training fighters. And this podcast is going to be great. Chance to talk boxing, people would ask questions. And about it.
You know you've asked.
Last question in this interview. Like who's the best trash talker?
Ellie, you know what? I'm going to have to charge you for
best
that.
Best trash talker in sports?
Yes.
Kevin Garnett.
Really?
Ooh, that's that one.
You think that, how about in boxing?
I don't think so, but I mean, Kevin Garnett was a notorious shit talker.
How about in boxing? Who's the best? Broner?
Not anymore.
I think he's slowly getting humble.
Sergey Kovalev.
Kovalev has been on fire lately with memes.
Yeah, when he told me he's gonna retire.
No, he had a better, he had a new one. He called him son of Kovalev, not son of God. Yeah, so he NBA your new.
Huh? I like that sparkling water.
All right, there you have it.
You stay tuned. Finish my answer.
Okay.
Okay. So what was the question?
biggest trash talker in boxing.
Today. Is there anyone?
Yeah, well, not anymore, but Broner was, a couple years ago, Broner.
Brandon, too?
Brandon. Oh, Brandon, by far. But Brandon just don't shit talk. I mean, Brandon literally goes for the jugular.
Cool. Do you ever run into boxing stars on the airport or different places you go, different cities, or you've been?
You know what? When I hung them up for a while there.
No fights, nothing?
I stayed away. I don't want to get that itch, you know, that a lot of fighters do get. I mean, I did get it a lot.
Like one more fight, one more comeback.
Yeah,
and you don't want to hurt yourself or hurt
yourself. Yeah, you know, there's no need for, be it said that for all the rumors, notorious, that I'm known for, you know, I haven't had to throw a punch in 5 years. I haven't had a punch in time pocket 5 years. So for all these horrible rumors, I mean, obviously, I doing something pretty damn right, you know.
You watch the Super Bowl. You're a big football fan, right?
Yes, I am.
What did you think of that crazy comeback? Like Mark Wahlberg? Did you get up after the first half, turn off the TV, and cuss at it?
No, because actually, the person I was watching it with was like, this is over. Actually, after the first drive in the third quarter, I was like, this is over with Sam, you know, and I'm like, I'm going, man, that's Tom Brady. I was like, it's not over with. The guy's smart. Again, that's why he is what he is, you know, where he's at. It was a great game. Unbelievable game.
After the game, someone went in the locker room, took a selfie with Tom Brady and jacked his jersey. I give the guy props on execution. That was impressive.
Did they catch him?
Yeah. He hid it under his shirt.
Really? When I was in the military.
Huh? Ain't that the like third time they stole Tom Brady's jersey, too?
Second.
Same guy.
Fucking klepto,
huh?
When I was in the military, we were helping out with Hurricane Katrina. And they stationed us in Stennis, Mississippi, where Brett Favre's hometown was. And they put us in his high school. His jerseys were in there. His high school, his college, and his pro jersey were on there. We could have took him if we wanted to. We wouldn't do it. I said, I'd be wrong. But they're in the glass for this destroyed high school.
Yeah, but I got a lot of my trunks places, but they're replicas. You know, like every pair of trunks that got made.
You made two or three.
Autographs, you know, certain things like that.
So, Kelly Pavlik, what is a former boxing star like yourself? What do you do since retirement? You retired, about 3 years ago, 4 years ago or so?
Five
years ago? Time flies.
Yeah, and that's scary, you know.
So, will you just raise your kid? Just live?
I gotta say, man, I took a break, but I've been busy a lot of things.
In no condition?
You know, my financial team, a lot of investments we got that are going good. But I actually got to a point.
But what do you think?
What's those investments were, you know, just me going like this on my phone and keeping up on them, you know. Wow. So it wasn't like
they were making money without working.
Yeah, it wasn't like I was staying active. I was actually getting bored.
Cool.
Then, you know, I started getting into other things.
Started
helping train fighters here and there.
Cool.
Then, you know, this podcast is kind of just new, but recently my kids with sports, you know, I'm coaching, help coach both of them.
What sports they play?
Baseball.
Specifically.
My daughter actually played all year long, you know, during the winter. And the big thing that I'm looking to do, I'm still kind of in debate, I want to open a boxing.
Do it.
Yeah, well, I do. I'm going to do it. You know, the thing is, right now, that's a full-time commitment, man. Like, you're looking at minimum 5 hours a day at the gym.
Minimum.
What do you get?
Try 13 hours a day and don't get paid for 7-8 of them because the gym is empty, and then one guy comes in, wants to sign up, and you never see him again.
He said that's a full-time commitment. At least 5 hours a day.
Well, I'm talking about minimum 5 hours.
What are you going to call it? The Kelster
2017?
Yeah, something like that. And, but you know, like I was saying, I don't know if I'm ready, if I have the time to do that yet. Okay. I kind of want to wait till my kids get a little older, like when they get to high school. Because when I open a gym, so I just say go on some little. I want to go all out. Like, I'm going to have a little kind of where you can have, like, cross training, like, athletes.
MMA corner.
You know, like that gym that in Columbus, that 51, you know, whatever. You know, like, you have other guys come in, and I can have my fighters do other workouts. Like, at that KO gym that you had, me working all that. So, you know, I want it to be the shit. You know, people get in the habit, they open up a boxing gym. It's expensive. Boxing equipment is expensive. They just get rinky-dink equipment. They think that they're going to make money doing it. Boxing is a long-term investment. I might have a head start because of being a former world champ, but it really is. Like, you got to wait for that one kid to walk through. And
just to break even.
Yeah, he may be 9, he may be 10, so you got to, you know, 9, 10, 11, 12 years before he starts making you money, you know. We'll see. I mean, I'm not worried about that.
Is this Keltron 2000?
There he is.
How's it going? Hey! Keltron. How are you guys feeling? That's Keltron 2000.
2020, homie.
2020. Yeah, how you feeling, Keltron? You're looking the same.
And I'll have the Caesar salad.
He sounds the same. What's up, C?
What's up, baby?
We got Marco Contreras. So first of all, Kelly, are you eating? I brought you pizza, man. I brought you pizza.
Oh, good, man.
Seriously?
He's actually going to order a salad.
Yeah, I'm looking at the braised duck. A lot of protein.
A lot of gains.
Where you been at, man?
Everywhere.
That's what I figured.
I've been.
You're still the busiest man in the show biz?
Pound for pound.
Still. Are you still hiding snakes in people's gym bags?
No, I took a break on that for a minute.
He just took a break. He just got back on it.
You know, okay. Kelly Pavlik against Conor McGregor? Because I know you train UFC fighters.
Yes, I do.
I know.
Kelly, if it's just pure boxing, if it's pure boxing, Kelly all day. Conor, he hits a lot harder. Nate Diaz does.
Yeah, you know what? I'm going to go ahead with that.
Nate Diaz made Conor his bitch.
He beat him twice. He beat him both times.
That's what I say.
I have my own radio show. Me and Kelly have our own radio show now. So
what's it called?
It's called The Punchline. Kelly Pavlik and James Dominguez.
There you go, man.
The Punchline.
Yeah.
Kelly's looking good. He hasn't aged a bit. Right?
Young, strong.
New haircut.
That's what you get when you sell your soul to the devil. You don't age.
Yeah.
So, there you have it. Another great video for ES News. For ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Ellie Sekpak, reporting. And you can follow me on Twitter, at Sekpak. And you can follow me on Instagram, at Ellie Sekpak. Take a step back. Ellie Sekpak.